What do you think of when you hear medieval surgery? Axes, swords, organs being torn out? Probably not very pretty. Well, this is true for some parts of the world at least. For example, medieval England, where when the only surgeon a person had was a sweaty barber, who probably never heard of hand wash, it's fair to say advancement in surgical knowledge was pretty rubbish. But whilst Europe was going through their dark ages, the golden age was happening in the Islamic world, with the emphasis of the value of knowledge in the Quran driving many to seek out new revelations. The progress of medicine was significant. New Arabic medical texts were key to understanding surgical techniques. The most influential surgical text was written by Abu Hasim Khalif ibn al-Abbas al-Zahrawi, or just al-Zahrawi for short. His book Kitab al-Tasrif would soon become the standard medical textbook of Europe in 1100. Born near the Spanish city of Cordoba in 936, Al-Zahrawi is accredited as the father of surgery. He famously described over 200 surgical instruments, many of which he developed himself, such as surgical scissors and grasping forceps. He detailed techniques such as applying ligatures for bleeding vessels and internal stitching using catgut. Oh, but don't worry, cat lovers, intestines don't need to be pulled out of kittens for this. Many of his procedures would revolutionise the fields in which he worked in. For example, he described a way to reset dislocated shoulders in a procedure which is today known as the Cotra method. He also used a surgical technique to relieve migraines, which has begun to be used again in the past decade. He was also a master dentist, performing the first ever 2-3 implantation in history. Al-Zahrawi's achievements are numerous, spanning a number of specialities. So if you're interested in discovering more, why not read the 33 volumes of his textbook? Today, this unsung hero's legacy continues to live on with every stroke of a surgeon's scalpel.